There are storms that we go through in life, not because they are there to kill us. They are to align us and to remind us of what God has said we shall do. God will allow the tempest, and the tempest will be so serious. You will try, you will be wasting your resources trying by all means to make things calm. Why can't you just do the will of God? God has given us these gifts and He wants us to work. But we have decided to do them half and relax. What is it that God has given you to do?
Join us today as Thembinkosi Dube shares the word of God.
We are reading the Bible in the book of Jonah. We'll just read chapter 1. Now the word of the Lord came to Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, "Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and call out against it, for their evil has come before me." But Jonah rose to flee to Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. He went down to Joppa and found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare and went on board to go with them to Tarshish, away from the presence of the Lord. But the Lord hurled a great wind upon the sea, and there was a mighty tempest of the sea, so that the ship threatened to break up. Then the mariners were afraid, and each cried out to his God. And they hauled a cargo that was in the ship into the sea to lighten it for them. But Jonah had gone down into the inner part of the ship and laid down and was fast asleep. So the captain came and said to him, "What do you mean, you sleeper? Arise, call out your God. Perhaps the God will give a thought to us that we may not perish." And they said to one another, "Come, let us cast lots, that we may know whose account this evil has come upon us." So they cast lots, and the lot fell on Jonah. Then they said to him, "Tell us whose account is this evil has come upon us. What is your occupation? And where do you come from? What is your country? And of what people are you?" And he said to them, "I am a Hebrew, and I fear the Lord, the God of heavens, who made the sea and the dry land." Then the men were exceedingly afraid and said to him, "What is this that you have done?" For the men knew that he was fleeing from the presence of the Lord, because he had told him. Then they said to him, "What shall we do to you that the sea may quiet down, for us?" For the sea grew more and more tempestuous. He said to them, "Pick me up and haul me into the sea. Then the sea will quiet down for you. For I know it is because of me that this greatest tempest has come upon me." Nevertheless, the men rowed hard towards the bank to get back to dry land, but they could not, for the sea grew more and more tempestuous against them. Therefore they called out the Lord, "O Lord, let us not perish for this man's life, and lay not us innocent blood for you. O Lord, have done as it pleased. For you, O Lord, have done as it pleased you." So they picked up Jonah and hauled him into the sea, and the sea ceased from its raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and they offered a sacrifice to the Lord and made vows. If you read the press, the media these days, there are a lot of stories about churches. Churches that are fighting. There is no peace in the churches. Some are splitting. Some people are fighting, and you wonder why, because this is God's church. Some are at loggerheads. If you read the press, the paper, there's a lot happening, not only in Eswatini, even globally. But this story, God revealed to me something different. Where we are reading, there is a man by the name of Jonah. This man has been sent by God to do a particular task which was clear to him. The Bible says God spoke to him and said, "Arise to Nineveh." God was clear to Jonah that you should rise and go to Nineveh. He was clear about that. Now, God's plan on this earth, we should know that it is to save humanity. The Bible in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4 says, it's referring to God, God who wishes all men to be saved and to perceive or increasingly perceive and recognize and discern and know precisely and correctly the divine truth of the saving power of God. So God, his main purpose on this earth is that we have a relationship with him, and that those who are lost, who fell from sin, every human being who fell from sin during the fall, be reconciled to God. That is God's main purpose. Ezekiel chapter 18 verse 23 says, have I any pleasure in the death of the wicked, declares the Lord God, and not rather that he should turn from his ways and live. This clearly shows us that God has a mission and has a desire that each and every person be saved. It is not God's desire that some people go to hell. It is not God's desire that people die not knowing about the saving grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Even if people sin, God gives them an opportunity to reconcile to them. In this particular point where we are reading, the people were sinning, of Nineveh were sinning, their sin had risen up to the Lord, and God wanted to sort out this issue, and he decided to turn to send his man as God. We know very well that God, although he has the mighty power to do things the way he wants to, but it is his decision that he uses humanity. God uses human beings to fulfill his purpose. Although he can do divine things, we know in the story of Goliath and David, that is found in the first book of Samuel, chapter 17, verse 50 to 53. God records that David threw a stone that killed the giant Goliath. God used men. So God uses men to accomplish his purposes on this earth. He is in heaven, but he uses human beings to do his things. And we are the human beings that are on this earth. God wants us to accomplish his task. Even Jesus Christ, before he left on this earth, you know that God can even send angels to preach to human beings, that instead of me, an angel can preach. God can do that. There is nothing impossible with God, so says the word. But God decided that human beings will preach to each other about me. That's why Jesus Christ said in Matthew chapter 28, verse 19, a common verse for evangelism, that go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We have been assigned to do the task of evangelism. God could have done it in a different way, but he sent humanity. It is his decision that he sent people. You are sent by God on this earth to accomplish something. God has actually said something. There is something that is in you that God has said you have to do. It is in you as I speak. You know exactly that God has said I should do this. It might be God has said you should go and preach, which is something that is most fearful. It might be God has said, go and help the needy. Go be somebody who specializes to care for people spiritually or care for people in counseling. We have different callings as human beings. Amen. So God in this particular time speaks clearly to Jonah and says to him, you go to Nineveh. Now, John, being a man like me and you, had perceived in his mind and has made it that everybody who does not accept God should go to hell. So in his mind, if you read Jonah 4, you get to understand what made Jonah not want to go to Nineveh. What made me not want to go, if you read verse 4, is that, but it displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he was angry. And he prayed to the Lord and said, oh Lord, is not this what I said when I was yet in my country? That is why I made haste to flee to Tarshish. For I knew that you were a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relenting from disaster. Therefore now, oh Lord, please take my life. In other words, Jonah had it in his mind that because the people of Tarshish deserve death, they should just die. They should not repent. He did not want that God's mercy or God's love be shown to the people of Nineveh. He did not want that. He just said, no, I don't want them to receive this great love of God. He had classified the people that they deserved hell. So he did not want them to enjoy the love of God. You know, God has sent us to say things, to do things on this earth. But because of our mindset that so and so is in this condition, let him relax on this condition, we cannot do. God is just done with him. There are people that God has sent us in the bars, in the prostitute where they sell their bodies, where the prostitutes sell. God has sent people to go and preach to those people in prison, in hospital, in different areas. But because we are human, we say these people deserve what they have. Sometimes God has said to you, go and help the poor, and he has given you money. And you said, no, I won't. They deserve to be poor. Their parents, why do they have so many kids? Why don't they plan? But God has sent us to do the work. Now, if you read the Bible, God wants us that we do things as he wants. But what is revealed also is his character in this story, the character of forgiveness. If people do his work, his word, God acts on his word. 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14 says, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal them. God does his word. Whatever we have perceived about the situation that this person deserves to go to hell, if the person repents, God accepts that person. So we are God's people and God has assigned us, but because of our perceptions about the people, they make us not to do the will of God. And God is not happy with that. But eventually, his will be done. If you read again, you continue on the story, Jonah decided that, let me just now go. You see, the way it is like he just went to the bus rank, if I can use our language. He went to the bus rank and took any bus. God says to me, for instance, go to Manzini and meet so-and-so and preach to him. And then I decide I go to the bus rank in Mbabane and just go there and see any bus that is going maybe to Stegi or to Spigi or to Nhlangano or to Bunya, to Liang. It's like that. Jonah did that. He just went to where the ship are and bought a ticket and went. In his mind, he was running from the presence of the Lord. Some of us, they just decide, God, because God has said I should do this, and you think, no, let me just go maybe to church and be part of the church and do anything that is there. God has been specific to you that you have to do this. I want you to do this. But in your mind, you have classified and said the situation is above me or I'm more on class than that. And then you just go to any church or to any place and you just do as you please. Whatever will work for me. Anyway, I'm still working for God. I want to call that half obeying God, because when you read here, the Bible said, go to Nineveh. And indeed, Jonah went, but not to the destination. So he did the word of God, half of it. So some people, they do the work of God. Maybe God says you should pray and be a prayerful person. You do pray, but not to the fullest. God has sent you maybe to the poor or to help the needy in church. But you say, oh, okay, let me go and help. You offer your money, but now you decide, no, let me offer it to the pastor. God has said, give it to the needy, but no, let me give it to the pastor or to whoever I think deserves it. God has given us assignments, but as human beings, we decide to do a half job. God might have assigned you to be someone who is a musician, just to sing songs. I was thinking this morning, I was playing on TV. So it's always nice in the morning if you wake up and you open nowadays, TV is on YouTube. You open YouTube, there is just a file, a full hour of somebody just worshiping God. You just listen to this, it revives you. But some of us have, no, let's not do that. Maybe it's too low for me or it's too whatever. And you do half the job. Let's do 100% God what he has sent us. Now, what Jonah did, he just took a boat, yet God saw whatever he was doing. He decided that, let me go down now to Tarshish and I'll see maybe what I'll do there. I just don't want to do what God says. It's amazing, or it's bad as human beings, that we have put aside God's instructions to do as we please. Unfortunately, God sees everything that is happening. God sees that you are not doing what he has said you should do. So now, Jonah went down and he did whatever he do. He actually went down to the lower deck just to hide, and he relaxed and he slept. It was a good time for him. What is the church today? There are many people God has assigned things to do in his church. When I'm talking about the church, I'm talking about the body of Christ. They've just come in and they are now relaxing. They are sleeping. God is worried. I've sent you to do my task. This is what I sent so and so to do. He's busy in the church just relaxing with the rest of the people. He's not preaching as assigned. He's not giving as assigned. He's not doing anything that God specifically was specific to him that you must do. But the person is relaxing. God now intervenes in the situation of Jonah. Now he says, no, let me just send a storm that will sort this situation. He had a plan that his word has to finally be done. Jonah had to finally get to Nineveh and preach. And then he decided, let me allow a storm to come that will make them to throw him into the sea, and I will prepare a fish. We know the story. And what happened was, there was a storm, a very bad one, serious one. God was working. In the storm, there is a person who does not want to do the will of God. God has allowed the storms. There are storms that we go through in life, not because they are there to kill us. They are to align us and to remind us of what God has said we should do. But because we want comfort and we don't want to listen to God, we've decided, no, let's go to Tarshish. Let's just do anything that is there. Whatever they say to me I should do, if I can speak in the context of a church, whatever they say I should do in church, I will do. If they say let me be in the kids ministry, I will be there. Whatever they say, if they say let me just be an usher, I'll be there. Yet you know very well that what God has said you must do. There are people who are engaged in different areas in the body of Christ. They know that they are assigned this, but they are not doing it. But they claim, at least I'm saved, I attend church. God wants us to do what he has said. I don't want to believe that some of us, they don't know what God has sent them. If God has sent you to preach, you have to preach. If he has sent you to the young people, be there. If he has sent you to prayer, you have to pray. If he has sent you to sing, you have to sing. If he has sent you to give, you have to give. We'll read the Bible in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 18 to 11. It talks about the different gift of the Spirit. Because as we accept God, as we accept Jesus Christ, God gives us the Spirit, and the Spirit comes with the gifts that we have to do. If you read, there is a spirit of utterance of wisdom. Some people have been given the Spirit just to utter wisdom. Some have been given to utter knowledge according to the same Spirit. Others faith. Others is healing. Others is working in miracles. Others is prophecy. God has said that. If you read Romans chapter 12, also speaks about the gifts. It leads a spirit of giving generously and the spirit of mercy. God has given us these gifts and he wants us to work, but we have decided to do them half and relax. What is it that God has given you to do? There is something that you need to do as a Christian, as somebody who is on this earth. And if you don't do it, God is going to bring a storm, because finally his word has to stand, because he's God. So the storm came to Jonah on the ship, and things were really bad. And he knew that he was the cause of the problem, because he did not want to do what God has said he should do. If I can say, there are some people who are not doing the will of God. And some of the storms that we see today in the church, God wants people to move out so they do what he sent them. I'm sorry to say this, but this is the story. This is what he's telling us. Some of us are relaxing. If we can bring it to a personal other than a church now, God has said this is what you should do, but you are not doing it. And God brings a storm in your life. Maybe you have a problem in your marriage, or you have a problem in whatever situation, or at work or whatever. God wants you to move out such that you can be thrown into the sea. And into the sea, you will remember God, like Jonah did in chapter 2. He prayed to God. And in his prayer, he remembered God. And when he was out of the fish, he did exactly what God said. So you can be pushed into a storm because God wants you to do exactly what he said to you. It is the difficult part when God now deals with you that I want you to do my thing. So don't resist. So the problems that we see maybe today in church, people fighting for position, people doing a lot of things, is because some of us are relaxing there. We know what God has sent us, but we are saying, no, God, somebody else, let him do it. We are on the wrong direction. Instead of going to Nineveh, we are going to Tarshish, where we want to. God has sent us to do something. I want to encourage and exhort each and every one of us that what is it that God is putting in you, that is burning in you, and you know very well, God said, I should do this, but you are not doing. You are just counting that at least I'm a member of the church, or at least I'm doing this. God wants you to do his task. Jonah was now thrown into the sea. He was kicked there, and the situation was bad. We could think that because if you look at the people on the ship, they tried by all means not to throw Jonah into the sea. Even after he had confessed that I am the one who is disobeying God, they tried to row to the sea, to a dry land, but they could not. Instead, the tempest was more strong. It was more strong. They were wasting resources. Actually, if you read the Bible, they had tried before they confessed, Jonah confessed, they had tried to take things out of the ship so it can be lighter, so it can float a little bit better, and they could be safe. It didn't work. And even after the confession, they tried to offload and to do what they can just to make sure that they get to dry land and they are safe. But the tempest was so mighty. God was at work. Some of us will try by all means to calm the situation in the church, to calm the situation in our lives, maybe where we disobeyed God. We don't want to do what he has assigned us. God will allow the tempest, and the tempest will be so serious. You will try. You will be wasting your resources trying by all means to make things calm. Why can't you just do the will of God? Because the Bible, we are on this earth for the purposes that God sent to us. As Mother Dube was making the testimony here about the person who had a dream and the near-death experience who went to heaven. And God said he should return because it was not the right time. In other words, he had not, or she had not, completed the task that he was sent to do. Because there is something you have to do on this earth. Once it is complete, you will die. God has sent you on this earth to do your work. Have you taken time to focus on what God has said to you? Some of us are even clear about what God has said, but we are not doing it. You are just relaxing like Jonah on the boat, and you are sleeping, and you are actually even hiding on the bottom. Hiding just to make sure they don't get me. I'm hiding for God. God, you can never hide for God. What is it that God assigned you to do? And if you know it, are you doing it? And if you are not doing it, you are causing problems. The people who are actually innocent, who should not be suffering from the storms, are suffering, your kids are suffering, your family is suffering. Those shouldn't be suffering because of you who does not want to obey God. Jonah's disobedience caused the captain and everybody, they lost their commodities, their goods into the sea because they were trying to save a situation for someone who just did not want to obey God. Because you are not someone who wants to do what God says to you, you are causing a problem to the people who should not be suffering. Your family, your church members, your everything is suffering. They're trying to save the situation. Yet you know very well this is what God has said you should do. We have an assignment to do on this earth. I don't mean to say to you, stop working. Some of you have been called to work. Even some people are called to business. Some are called to medicine too. There are different things we've been called to. As long as you know that God, what I'm doing, God has called me to do. Now, as we come to the application, I want you to recall what God has sent to you. If you are clear about it, please don't relax and work on it. This morning, as I was in the house, I was just thinking, we don't have, for instance, we don't have content for Key Sunday School in here in Eswatini on YouTube. Whoever was just recording, if you can find it, was just recorded on a phone. We don't have content that they can watch our kids on YouTube other than them watching Bob Bluey. What are we providing as the Christian church? There's an opportunity. There are people that have been sent to do that, but they are not. So God wants us to work. But as we come to the application, please reflect on yourself. What is it that God has sent you to do? Before things get out of hand and a lot of resources are wasted and innocent people get hurt, get up and do what he has sent you to do. And if you know, but you have deferred it, please take your time to confess to God. Lord, please forgive me. I've sidelined what you've assigned me to do. One of the biggest temptations that we have as human beings today, especially those who are working, is that I will start to do my task at retirement. That's one of the things that we say. I'm still taking my kids to school. I'm still focusing on this. Well, that is your reason, but God does not work with retirees. He also wants people who have energy, people who can think, people who can run, people who are active. If you read the Bible, you get a lot of people, God, that he used that were energetic. David himself, as I've referred, was a young man. You talk about Solomon, you talk about the different people, even in the New Testament, John was born and he did the work of God. All his life he dedicated to God. There were different people. I don't remember seeing one of them who was a retiree, who started to be a prophet at 60. God uses people who are energetic. He also wants energetic people. Don't wait for retirement. And some of these tasks doesn't actually mean you have to stop working. You can do them whilst you're still working. But what is important is that God, you do what God has assigned you. You might know it, but fear of doing it. Stop being afraid. Just do it. God will make a way. The other thing is that you know it, but you think maybe I'm not the rightful person to do it. What has caused that? Maybe some of it are the structures that we have. But some of it is just your own fear and your own perceptions. Just like Jonah had the perception that, no, they don't deserve to be saved. God, what he has assigned you to do, you need to do. Maybe God has sent you to give students some funds, but you don't want to do it because you have classified those children that they will be nothing. God has a purpose for each and every person on this earth. And none of us has been sent for nothing. And all of us, we have to accomplish what God has said we should do. We have to do it. The Bible says in John 9, verse 4, we must do the work of him who sent me while it is still day. Night is coming when no one can do, when no one can work. So there's a time that is coming where we will not be able to work. Why can't we just focus on what God has sent us to do? Why can't we just do what God says, just do, and do the way He has sent it should be done? He will provide the resources, He will provide the material, He will provide the people, all the people, because the resources are human resources and money and everything. As long as you know that this is what God has said I should do, you do it. Because there is a time coming where the clock will say, your time is over on this earth, Thembinkosi. You have to leave. And when you leave, you have to give an account to God. Did you do what you were assigned? It was fortunate for Jonah. He was given an opportunity, a second chance by God. After the fish has vomited, had vomited him, the Bible said in chapter 3, the word of the Lord came again. It hasn't changed. It says, arise, go to Nineveh. The same words that he received in chapter 1. So delaying doing God's work and doing your assignment only puts you into a vulnerable situation and costs you resources, even people that are around, as I've said. But doing the work of God at the beginning will save you. And the word of God and what God says to you, said to you, and is saying to you today will never change. Even after the storms of life, it will come back to you. If you haven't died, God has saved you. He will still remind you, remember, I told you to do this. Please do it. And you'll eventually have to do it. Well, that's the end of the sermon. There is an action that you have to do. If you are not doing God's work, please realign yourself and do it. If you are doing work, or the Lord said you should do, that's great. Let's celebrate. Let's keep working. Let's work hard and make sure we do it thoroughly and perfectly. May God give us the courage and strength just to continue to do the tasks ahead. It's an honor to do the work of God and to fulfill His earthly purpose. May God richly bless us, and we will meet next time, God willing. Goodbye.